My absolute favorite thing about being sober, though, is that I don't have to think about pot. Because, I used to use pot for anxiety. Like, I would, I'd get really high, and then that would really take my anxiety to new levels. I'd get really high, and then I'd figure out the secrets of the universe, and it's not good news, you know? And the worst for me is edibles. Edibles were awful for me. They're too intense these days. It's not okay anymore. We gotta put the plug in it, you know? And if you've ever had edibles, you know exactly what I'm talking about. Because you're still high right now. From that one time. If you don't know, edibles are a time-release drug, which means that you take them, and then you are released from time. You don't... just never to be seen again. I had a very bad experience one time on edibles in Chicago. I was traveling to Chicago with that same boyfriend from the Cookie Monster story, and he had these cute little Jolly Ranchers with weed in them, and he gave me one. And I was like, how much of this should I take? You know, and he was like, do like a quarter of it. And I was like, cool. It's a Jolly Rancher. I did not come to Chicago with a diamond cutter today, so... I just ate it. And then I got very high. You know, and then 4 hours went by and I got way more high because there's no brakes on that train. It just gets worse. And I was like, all right, I'm pulling the plug. I gotta go back to the hotel and cry and drink Gatorade and flush this out. I can't do this anymore. And he was like, we can't go back to the hotel. I forgot, we're meeting up with my friend Ted. You've never met him before, but he's really, really cool, and he's so excited to meet you. And so we waited, and then Ted showed up, and he was like, hey, Alice, I'm Ted. Oh my God, I'm so excited to meet you. I can't wait to show you my Chicago. And I was like, oh, hey, babe, you forgot to mention that your friend is a demon. From another dimension. We've got to get out of here. We couldn't get out of there. We had to go see Ted's Chicago. And what Ted's Chicago amounted to was the top of a very tall building in which there was a very fancy restaurant, which he wanted us to go to, not so we could eat there, but so that we could stand in the vestibule of the restaurant and stare out the window past all the people who were eating dinner there, who were, and this is important, not tripping balls. I was like, Ted, this is such a great idea. How did you think of such an amazing plan for us? You take the highest people you've ever met and bring them to the highest place you could think of. So that they could just stand in a weird clump, kind of trying to not look like they're even existing, while staring out this window past all these normal folk from Chicago who were just having their fancy, fancy dinners, and they're eating their foie gras and their caviar and their weird, like, you know, dessert towers things that they're putting on their, in their gullets, you know, their big Chicago fat cat gullets that they, you know, they're just spending all this money that they've obviously reaped off the backs of the Chicagoan workers below that I can see, almost see out there in the Babylon suffering under this thick layer of pollution that they can't get enough money to put in their pockets to give their kids the small dish pizza that they want. You know, it's just the thin crust is all they can afford because these fat cats up here, they won't stop getting the money and spilling it, the grease on their wide ties. And I'm screaming all this aloud in the restaurant. And my boyfriend had to be like, she's in an improv team. That's how you get out of that, if you ever need to.